Please welcome Memory Banda, an activist fighting to end child marriage in Malawi.
Good afternoon. My name is Memory Banda. I'm honored and humbled to be here today as we continue as we continue to promote democracy and defend human rights around the world. I come from Malawi, a country well known recently as a model for democracy because it's full of noble people who are actually taking active role in ensuring that they are a part of the political processes that are going on in the country. At the same time, there are still developmental challenges that actually Malawi is still struggling to overcome today. One of the biggest situations is the situation of girls and women who are still struggling to reach their full potential. Despite the progress on gender equality, girls and women still face discrimination in every aspect of their lives. Girls are more likely to drop out of school, and women have less access to land, credit, and even finding jobs to actually sustain themselves. And further to that, there is race representation of women in the decision-making positions. I believe that Malawi will not be able to fully become a developed country if half of its population is actually left behind. And women still face a lot of obstacles, whether social, economic, and politically. And I believe that it's high time women in Malawi, not just in Malawi, but across the globe, claim for their spaces. Another unique problem that is actually facing Malawi today is the issue of child marriage. Child marriage is actually a very, very big problem that is not only affecting Malawi, but so many other developing countries. And let me tell you, child marriage is actually a big telling sign that women everywhere in the world, especially girls, are not valued. And it is also a telling sign that women and girls will still have the lowest status in our communities which we come from. Child marriage is also a telling sign that most of the human rights are being neglected. And it is also a telling sign that the governments, so many governments, are failing women and girls across the world. Child marriage cannot be a sideline issue. Child marriage every year affects about 14 million girls around the world. And one in three girls get affected by child marriage and they get married before the age of 18. And one in nine girls get married before the age of 15. Some in even worse situations as young as 10. Child brides are actually often exposed to so many challenges and they go through traumatic experiences, and the most painful thing is actually to see them going through premature pregnancy, and most of the times they are actually infected with sexual transmitted infections such as HIV and AIDS. And as you all know, child marriage is also closely linked with a low level economic income at a household level. And at the same time, you wouldn't actually expect a child who was married off, for example, at the age of 15 to actually educate her children. It means that she will be economically dependent on someone, and at the same time, she won't be able to support her children. This entails that the circle of poverty will keep on going from generation to generation. In the community where I actually come from, child marriage is equally celebrated like any other marriage. Imagine a marriage of a 13-year-old. They go into church, celebrate like an ordinary marriage. I feel like it's high time that has to be stopped. And that can only happen with people in this room, with people everywhere in the world watching me right now. Child marriage has always been, in the community where I come from, has not really been recognized as one of the human rights violations. Instead, it is viewed as an issue that is too sensitive to talk about. It is also looked at as something that is too difficult to confront. And it is actually deeply attached to our traditions and beliefs and norms. That's why it is taken as a normal thing. But I believe that that is changing now. It is changing because we are now seeing a lot of girls and women speaking out. I have seen girls standing up, amplifying their voices, demanding their rights, demanding for their space. And I have seen women rising up, connecting with each other, recreating a generational conversation that these things need to be stopped. And I have also seen boys and men standing up. I have seen local and traditional leaders against this harmful practice. But there is more that we can actually do, because up to date, millions and millions of girls are being lost through child marriage. Before I go further, I would like you to know a little bit about me, and people looking at me, who is this girl? I am actually 23 years old, and I have my little sister who was married off at the age of 11. She got pregnant and she was married off. This was not questionable because this was like a tradition. An adolescent girl gets married off and nobody does anything about it. I saw her dreams being shattered. I saw her goal, and she had a dream of becoming a nurse. She never achieved that. Her childhood was actually lobbed from her. Her dreams were shattered. I have also witnessed my cousins, my family friends, and my classmates being married off. A lot of girls have been married off and their dreams have been shattered. There are thousands and thousands of girls like my sister. Their lives, their future, they have been destroyed. I had a lot of questions when I was growing up. Why should girls go through this? Why should girls actually, when she's growing up, her future should be defined? Why should somebody or lady light her story? Why can't she have the audacity, the power, the courage to light her own story? Why should somebody decide on her behalf? I decided I could be that girl to change the situation of girls like my younger sister. I rose up. I did not keep quiet. I made a lot of obstacles. I was so young, I was 13, but I had my guts up. And I was like, if I don't stand up, nobody will. Then I did stand up and I rose and I amplified my voice. And further to that, I remember a lot of injustices happening to a lot of girls. And I began to speak out. My first encounter was to speak to the traditional leaders, because child marriage can't happen without them. They bless the marriage. The religious leaders, they are there bracing these children into marriages. And I questioned them. We went further and I actually started hearing the voices of girls, relating with them, telling them you can start speaking out about this. And they started speaking out. With me together, our voices was greater in my community. A lot of things changed in my community. But I said, these things are changing in my community. But what if we take it further? This issue of child marriage is not only affecting my community, but it's a national wide issue. And we took it further and we actually lobbied the government. We started advocating for the change of legal marriage age, because then it was actually 15. We advocated, met the members of parliament, and I started this campaign called I Will Marry When I Want. This campaign now became a global campaign. We started speaking out. The legal marriage age was changed in 2015, and by then I was young. And I looked myself and I said, yes, No matter how young you are, you have the ability to change things. People can listen to you if you rise up. Through my work, I have gone further to actually look in 2016 to 2017. I said, yes, the law has changed. What more? In our constitution, there was a different definition of who is a child. We needed to harmonize that. I went on another campaign to ask the government to amend the constitution and actually remove all the irregularities and define a child or persons below the age of 18. This campaign seemed impossible. I met a lot of people, like members of parliament, and they were asking me, you are asking for too much, memory. In 2015, you asked for this, it happened. And do you know what it takes to amend the constitution? Do you know how much money has to go into that? I said, I know, and the government has that. And it's not just the government, but we have the global community. They are here to support us. We went on that campaign, and it really happened in 2017. The constitution was amended, and a lot of people were actually surprised. So all these actually show that change is really, really possible. This campaign actually favored us because the first lady joined us and she was a part of our campaign and she became our goodwill ambassador. Despite all these legal victories, I believe that preventing child marriage is actually a multifaceted project. It's about getting our girls into school and knowing how to keep them there. It's about ensuring they have access to sexual reproductive health and rights, and actually including the services, that's the whole pack of our sexual reproductive health and rights. And further to that, it's also about giving girls economic opportunities and proper trainings these girls need to be empowered. For us to keep this momentum, we need the coalition of everyone. Everyone needs to be involved. If we lose the momentum right now, we might never actually achieve the goal that says that we will end child marriage by 2030, and we are only remaining, we just have a decade. So we need to ask ourselves as leaders, how far are we? Because child marriage is a global challenge. Child enforced marriage is also an international problem, and it actually needs urgent attention. Ultimately, it's going to take a massive coalition, including girls, boys, parents, religious and community leaders, politicians, and of course, the international community, to speak out against this harmful practice and all the practices that are actually attached to child marriages. Prioritizing girls and women is one of the most fundamental sounds of changing our world for the better. I have actually learned that encouraging girls and women to help themselves raises the living standards for an entire society. Rates leave no one behind. An empowered and educated girl becomes an agent of change. I firmly believe that it does not matter where one is born, we are all global citizens, and we are all promised the same rights. And we must join our hands together as one community to protect our fundamental freedoms and to call on all the world leaders to ensure that we are living in an equal, equitable society where everyone flourishes. Thank you very much.